Welcome to this video on drug suffixes. Remembering thousands of drug names and what they do is an enormous task, so I'm hoping this video will help you in your study of pharmacology. First, we'll take a look at some blood pressure medications. ACE inhibitors end in pril, such as captopril and lisinopril. ACE inhibitors reduce blood pressure by dilating blood vessels, thus reducing the heart's workload. Beta blockers end in LOL, such as atenolol, propranolol, and labetalol. Beta blockers reduce blood pressure by slowing the heart rate and reducing myocardial contractility. They are given for hypertension, CHF, and chronic heart failure. Drugs ending in dipine are calcium channel blockers, such as amlodipine and nifedipine. Calcium channel blockers relax blood vessels, therefore increasing blood supply and oxygen to the heart, reducing the heart's workload and lowering blood pressure. Angiotensin II receptor antagonists or blockers, or ARBs, end in sartan, such as losartan and valsartan. ARBs inhibit blood vessel constriction, helping blood vessels relax, which lowers blood pressure. Diuretics are often used in conjunction with blood pressure medication. Drugs ending in actone are potassium-sparing diuretics, such as spironolactone, also known as aldactone. These diuretics increase the fluid passed out by the kidneys, while retaining potassium in the body, considered a weak diuretic. Thiazide diuretics end in thiazide and are used mainly for treating high blood pressure and edema, but potassium is lost in the process. Hydrochlorothiazide, or HCTZ, is commonly used. Let's look at another group of drugs that cause hypotension or low blood pressure as a side effect, but with other intended purposes. Drugs used to treat erectile dysfunction end in afil and include sildenafil or Viagra, vardenafil or Levitra, and tadalafil or Cialis. These medications cause direct coronary vasodilation, and special precautions should be taken in men with cardiovascular disease. Let's go over a few more cardiovascular drugs. Statins, or anti-lipidemic drugs, end with, you guessed it, statin, including atorvastatin, or Lipitor, and simvastatin, or Zocor. These are anti-cholesterol drugs that reduce LDL cholesterol and cardiovascular disease. Thrombolytic drugs end with ACE, such as streptokinase or alteplase, which is also known as TPA, tissue plasminogen activator. These are clotbuster drugs given to break down unwanted blood clots, causing heart attacks and strokes. The sooner treatment is given, the quicker blood flow is restored to the area. If the medication ends with arin, it's most likely an anticoagulant, such as heparin or warfarin. Anticoagulants prevent blood coagulation or prolong the clotting time. Now let's take a look at some antibiotics. There are tetracyclines, which have an easy ending, cycline, such as tetracycline or doxycycline. These broad-spectrum antimicrobial drugs are used in treating and preventing bacterial infections. Aminoglycosides are another antibiotic, ending with mycin, such as erythromycin and vancomycin. Fluoroquinolones are a broad-spectrum antibiotic ending with floxacin, such as ciprofloxacin and levofloxacin. While antibiotics treat bacterial infections, antivirals treat a virus infection. If the ending is VIR, it's most likely an antiviral, such as acyclovir. Let's turn our focus to some drugs that treat intestinal issues. Drugs ending in azine, such as promethazine, are an antiemetic, used to treat nausea and vomiting. Proton pump inhibitors end with prazole, such as lansoprazole, or Prevacid, and omeprazole, or Prilosec. These are anti-ulcer drugs that reduce gastric acid production. Another anti-ulcer drug is the H2 receptor antagonists, or H2 blockers, which block the action of histamine in the stomach, decreasing the production of stomach acid. These drugs usually end in tadine, such as cimetidine or Tagamet, famotidine or Pepcid, and ranitidine or Zantac. We've included a couple of common respiratory drugs. Bronchodilators dilate the bronchi and bronchioles, decreasing resistance in the airway and increasing airflow to the lungs. These medications are given for asthma and COPD and include drugs ending in terol and phylene, such as albuterol, levobuterol, theophylline, and aminophylline. Antihistamines are given to treat allergy symptoms, such as sneezing, runny nose, itching, or hives, and include drugs ending in INE, such as diphenhydramine, loratadine, and brofenaramine. Medications used to treat depression and anxiety include the following. Drugs ending in PAM or LAM are most likely a benzodiazepine, which are used to treat anxiety, and prolonged use may lead to physical dependence. Benzodiazepines include alprazolam or Xanax, diazepam or Valium, and lorazepam or Ativan. Several tricyclic antidepressants end in tryptyline, such as amitriptyline and nortriptyline. These drugs are used to treat depression, bipolar disorder, anxiety, OCD, and other mood disorders. SSRI or selective serotonin reuptake inhibitors block or delay the reabsorption of serotonin and are used to treat major depressive disorders and anxiety disorders. You'll find that they end in PRAM or INE, such as fluoxetine or Prozac, sertraline or Zoloft, citalopram or Celexa, and escitalopram or Lexapro. As I near the end of the list, there are a few that didn't fall into the earlier categories. Drugs ending in cane are local anesthetics, such as lidocaine and xylocaine. Local anesthetics prevent the transmission of nerve impulses or pain without causing unconsciousness. Corticosteroids are anti-inflammatory drugs used to control many different symptoms, but not a cure for the underlying disease process. Most corticosteroids end in sone or lone, including dexamethasone, prednisone, methylprednisolone, and triamcinolone. Oral hypoglycemic agents lower blood sugar for the diabetic patient and include drugs ending in IDE, such as gliburide and glipizide. Thank you for watching this video on drug suffixes. Click the link for a full list of the drugs we mentioned in this video.